Sean Aubenois.
Yes, sir.
First of all, welcome to Bermuda. You're here to put some pressure on some familiar foe for you, Aaron Evans. But what are you hoping to get out of this weekend's national championships right here in Bermuda?
You know, just to have fun, come out here and, you know, see Bermuda for what it is and, you know, just do the best I can. I know Aaron is a great competitor, so I know it'll be a good race.
Now, what do you know about the humidity here? You've been here, you've been around the track for a little bit today. What have you learned about this area here?
I actually like it. I was talking to Aaron earlier and he was saying that it's really humid here, and coming from Florida where it's always humid, I guess I'm kind of used to it, so I enjoy it. You know, the weather is nice and breezy, so it'll be good.
Now, it's always a breeze one way or the other here at this stadium. What times are you looking to post in the 800?
I mean, whatever happens will be, you know, sufficient, so I'm just going to come out here and give it a good race.
Raced against Aaron over the years in college. What are some of the memorable battles you guys have had?
Well, we had definitely gone against each other in some of the championships, and Aaron had gotten the best of me, so, you know, hopefully, you know, we'll have a nice competitive race here later this week.
Without giving out too many secrets right from the start?
We'll see.
All right, well, welcome and good luck.
Thank you.
What are some of the things you're hoping to accomplish in the sport of athletics?
I don't know if I can necessarily say. I just want to become the best athlete that I can. I've come a long way, especially from high school. I never, like, went to state or anything, but then here I am, a national champ at the D3 level. So I know there's still more potential, so just utilizing that to its full potential.
Now, for those that don't know, there's the three divisions at the college level, which is D1, D2, D3.
Correct.
But when you compare times, there's not that much difference, is it?
I mean, there's some. So, like, I wanted a 208, and then D1, you're going to see about a 202.
Mm-hmm.
But at the D3 level, you don't get any athletic scholarship. It's more, you can only get academic scholarships. So you're there more for your academics versus athletics.
Right.
So
the fact that you're smart and you're athletic and talented, it only benefits you all around.
Correct. Yes, it does.
So now, outdoors, you earned the Franklin College, the Heartland Collegiate Athletic Conference Women's Track and Field Athlete of the Week. That was back in May, March?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. So you're here in Bermuda. Obviously, are you enjoying yourself so far?
Yes, definitely. Kyle's taking good care of me.
Okay. And yes, Kyle, you're due to be here with us today as well. Kyle has just gone to run an errand, but he's promised to come back.
Yes, he did.
And join us on the set. But for those that don't know how technical, because you're an 800 meter run.
Correct.
For those that don't know how technical that race could be, break down a particular race for you at the D3 national championship level.
So the D3 meet is definitely tactical. We got out pretty quick though, but that's pretty normal for my race plan. I get out quick, and then you just find your pace, and then you got to finish hard. So I got boxed in both in the prelims and in the finals. So that kind of throws your race plan off a little bit, but that's part of being a runner, is just being able to go with every situation that comes your way. So 200 to go, I was boxed in and had to almost come to a complete stop to get around. And then you just have to trust in your training and finish out strong. So
you almost have to box your way out of being boxed in.
Yep, exactly.
Now, when you're competing, obviously, overseas, there's the level of competition is far, well, I wouldn't say, the opportunity to compete at a higher level is always there.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, talking to Kyle and others from Bermuda, at meets in Bermuda, we don't often get all the elite athletes to sort of raise the bar. But what are you expecting to accomplish here?
I'm just expecting to get a better time, have some another more competition, running with Kyra and helping her to do her best as well. So just here to help the locals and enjoy my time as well. So
now, you say you're a fast starter. Do you anticipate the humidity here in Bermuda affecting your mental preparation for that?
It's definitely been a concern of mine, but being here a couple days early helps me adjust to the atmosphere. But the race will be at night, so it'll be a lot better, and I like to say I'm a good night racer, so that's in my favor.
No, you say it's at night. It's 8 o'clock, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, that's still evening time. people are still at the beach, and people are still there. Yeah. So but Kyra's been one of the special ones that we've had over the years.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that now she'll be competing against someone who's where she's trying to get to, which is going to be a collegiate career in the very near future. Just what's some of the things that you can tell her that you've experienced over your short career, especially in college?
What kind of took me to the next level is just having the confidence and believing in myself. My coach has always said, hey, you could always win national championship, and I said, there's no way, like, I can't do that. But once you reach the point of believing in yourself and knowing that you can do it, then you can do it. So
yeah,
that's one of the biggest pieces of advice I have is you have the talent, you just have to believe it, and if you want it, go after it.
Were you surprised that you ended up winning the national championship?
I didn't necessarily say surprised, but there was a lot of good competition, but it was something I prepared for, and it was something I wanted, so I went after it and got it.
Coming across the line after, almost like you said, coming to a complete stop, and then overtaking everyone, what was that feeling like as you crossed the line?
I couldn't believe that I had just won. It was just so surreal, and I just wanted to talk to my family, and I was just like, did I really just win? And that my coach was there, and it was just a really happy moment because it was the same day I graduated from college, so it was a very special day.
Oh, one you'll never, ever, ever forget.
Nope, never forget.
Okay. Well, we have been joined by Kyle Webb. Good afternoon, Kyle.
Afternoon.
You've had a rather interesting season.
Yeah, it has been interesting being out there in Arizona. You have to experience a lot of different things. Some years you got some good performances. Others you stay more consistent. That's the key. You don't want to range too far off from your consistency. So you do the best you can do.
Now I've been tracking you for a little while now, and I've looked at the times, and you're right. As long as you're consistent.
Yes.
And you've been consistent in the one. You've been consistent in the two and the four.
Yes.
You're back now. It's a chance to show some of your friends what you've been doing over the course of the last year as far as improving. What do you think is going to be your biggest challenge during the national championships?
I mean, there's going to be some big contenders out there, so it's going to be a lot of fun. My big challenge, just stay relaxed. Stay relaxed and do what you gotta do. Don't worry about making friends. We're all out there having fun, and even though we're friends and everything, during the race, we're all competitors, so we all gotta do what we gotta do.
So, come Friday, you sort of get into a zone, you block everybody else out, because I know you like to warm up if your headphones on and you go off into another world sort of thing. Are you still doing the same routines you used to do here, or have you picked up some little tiny tips?
I do the same things I always used to do. Stay consistent with what you used to do and what you're comfortable with. Go off into my own little world and stay focused. I know we're all friends and everything, but I mean, during the race time, all of that goes behind us.
Yeah. What are some of the things you've learned about yourself over in Arizona throughout the course of the year?
Being out in Arizona helps you you grow up in the environment. Being home, away from home, you're all by yourself. You gotta do what you gotta do. Athletics-wise, stay humble. We didn't have a very good region,
mm-hmm.
So you just gotta stay humble with the athletics and get your skill work done.
Yeah, having Bruce there sort of helps.
Yeah, Bruce helps me what I gotta do and keeps a little part of home.
Right. Now, obviously, you're chauffeur today?
Yeah.
just the different types of competition that you guys have faced over your careers thus far. What would you say, Alan, would you say has been one thing that would stand out for you that you would always go back to sort of inspire yourself when you get back on the track?
I think it's those times when you don't, like, sometimes you, in your conference, you tend to always win, but then when you get to other meets outside of that, your last chance meets before nationals, you get into the greater competition. Sometimes you get beat, but sometimes that, it is hard at the moment, but it just pushes you to be stronger, and ultimately, if you want it like I did, you work harder and you go after and get it, so.
Now, as you said, sometimes you weren't always the best. But working hard, what are some of the things you were doing to make sure that you were able to get, or the coach was able to get the most out of you in training and then for competition?
Well, I had a balance of school, and I was a resident assistant in our dorm, and I had a balance a lot in your senior year. You're trying to look for jobs, trying to figure out what you're doing, so you just have to balance a lot, so you just have to figure out what your priorities are and where they are, and staying healthy and busy in the training room, and making sure that you're eating well, sleeping well, and just so you can perform at your best.
Now, you spent some time this morning at the track.
I did.
What did you think of the stadium?
It's really nice. Big grandstand. We don't necessarily have that at Franklin College, but it's more like it was at like I was at the national meet, so I'm excited. Yeah. So I was surprised it was so hot already at like 9 o'clock, but it was good.
Yeah. Kyle, you're back, been doing a little training as well. What are the conditions, how do the conditions differ from what you've been into in Arizona to what's back at home?
It feels great being back home. The big difference between being back home, the track feels very bouncy. So right. Being out in Arizona, the track is hard. It's like concrete. Where you come back home, you're just amazed at how bouncy the track is. Yesterday I was out there doing some work, some last little touches. It felt wonderful, so I'm ready for some good competition.
Yeah. Now, can that change your style of running if you're used to a hard surface and that's what you compete on all the time, and then you come to a spongy, soft track? Can that change your running style? Can it change anything in your technique?
Not really. It's just a part of the track and field life. You're gonna always experience different tracks. I experienced indoor season this year. It was a big change for me. I didn't like it at all.
Well, I was getting to that. Yeah. Trust me, I was getting to that.
Yeah, it was crazy. But it's just a part of the sport. You experience different tracks, different feelings, but you just got to still do what you got to do out there.
Right. Let's talk a little bit about the indoor, because it's a different kettle of fish. Running, we'll go back to Anna. Running an 800 indoor is totally different than running an 800 outdoor.
Yes, it is.
Strategically, how do you manage the difference, the indoor 800 to the outdoor 800?
It is different, but for me, like, in the outdoor, I break my race down into the 200, so having that every lap. Indoor, it's not too much different. It's just there's more turns, so it does affect somebody with longer legs.
Right.
I don't know. It's kind of fun. It's just, like you said, it's a different ball game, but it's still fun for me. So.
Okay, which one do you prefer then?
I definitely prefer outdoor.
Okay, all right. And I know Kyle's gonna say, hey, not outdoor for me, but that's what you grew up on, outdoor.
Yes.
When you first go into the indoor track, new environment, and the fact that you're doing sprints, does your training habit change? Does your mindset change? What changes?
Going into a race plan for 400 indoors is very difficult, because you're worried about running up hills, running on your bank. You got two laps, so you gotta judge your race different than outdoors, where it's a flat and you know what you're doing. It's just a full 400, whereas you got two 200s indoor, and that second lap kills.
Right.
That second lap, the backstretch going uphill is crazy.
Because of the shape of it, it does slope a lot.
Yeah.
What lane would you prefer if you had to run it again?
Indoors, I don't even know. I still haven't gotten used to it.
Inside and outside lanes are just as hard, eh?
Yeah, but I prefer the middle, whereas you see everybody in front of you, and you're getting chased behind you, whereas at the cut-in, at the 150 mark, you gotta be out there first.
And obviously in Bermuda, you face the, one way or the other, you're gonna face a headwind.
Yeah.
No matter which way you look at it,
yeah.
You're just gonna face a headwind. taking this experience that you had as a youngster in Bermuda, the challenges of always being in all sorts of conditions. You run in rain, cold, headwind, tailwind, all sorts of things. How did that help you once you got to Arizona and you started training and getting into competition?
Well, I kind of, when I was home growing up, I always thought the how bad do you want it video. Mm-hmm. It kind of encouraged me to go out there and do what I gotta do, because it was a urge, because I saw him training so hard, and just listen to the lyrics, you think, oh, I'm training in the rain, so I'm out here for it. It feels like you're doing something positive and you're doing something strong, but converting it to going out to Arizona, you're transferring all this bipolar weather in Bermuda to dry heat in Arizona.
Right.
Dry heat and windstorms. So you kind of adapt to the weather changes and everything. And I mean, either way you go, everywhere you go, everywhere's going to be different. So you still got to zone in and do you.
After the national championships, what's in your immediate plans?
Right now I'm taking 4 online classes to finish up at Central Arizona.
Mm-hmm.
I signed a full ride scholarship to Purdue University.
Okay.
And I'm not even running for Bermuda. This is my last meet for the season, so I'm still going to be training and everything, but other than that, I got to take care of these classes, so I got to move on.
Right. Well, we wish you well in that regard, because education is important. You just heard Anna talk about she graduated and then she won the national championships.
Yeah, I'm trying to follow in her footsteps. Graduated from college.
Yeah. Well, got 2 hard things to do: graduate and win a national championship.
Yeah, that's the plan.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, make it there first.
Well, hey, but take care of one thing for at a time, and that's obviously this summer taking care of those 4 classes that you have to do.
Yeah.
But having Bruce with you in school, and watching him perform as well, what sort of battles do you guys have to motivate each other to make sure that you're at your top of your game?
Make sure we both stay focused.
Mm.
I know there's a lot of other Islanders there and all the Americans out there cheering us on, but still keep a little piece of home with us. So we all throw on the track, encouraging each other to do better. Look back at home, so say we go home and do what we got to do and represent our country and not alone our parents and our family.
Mm-hmm. Now, Anna, if you had to do any other event, which you probably have, what would be your other favorite event to do?
I like the 400 as well. Coming into college, that's what I did, but then I found that my specialty was the 800. So I still enjoy the 400 and the 4x4. 4x4 is always exciting. It's the end of the meet. Everybody's excited.
Right.
Sometimes it determines who wins the meet, so it's always exciting. So that's probably my next favorite.
How did you determine that the 800 suited you better than the 400?
I mean, it's kind of trial and error. I used to be a soccer player in elementary school and then moved, and they didn't have soccer at my school, so I transitioned into cross country and didn't like the long distance, but it helped my endurance.
Right.
And I still had the speed from soccer, and 800 just seemed like the right fit. So.
Yeah. Okay. And how would you rate yourself as a 400?
Well, they put me anchor legs, so they tend to say anchor legs are the quickest. So.
Would you agree with that?
Hey, I stay in my lane. I stay in my lane.
Yeah, well, I mean, they say anchor legs should be strong, but if you're that far behind when it gets to the anchor, you're in a lot of trouble, aren't you?
They say anchor's the fastest, but most second legs the strongest.
Okay, all right. We've got a battle of the track and fielders here. Okay, all right. We've got a speedster and a distance, middle distance. But, Kyle, give us a sense of a day's training for you over in Arizona.
It was kind of a set schedule.
Mm-hmm.
Some days we would have a 500 breakdown. 500 breakdown would consist of 500, 400, 300, 200, 100. Or we would do a 600 breakdown of 600, 400, 300, 200.
And it has to be done in a required amount of time? Or
that depends. Preseason, more like 75, 80%.
Right.
During the season, it would... We would break a 500 down into a 300 and a 200. And I don't know, those coaches have different theories than some coaches. so I would question it sometimes, but I mean, without what coach you go to, you gotta trust their program and hope that it's the best for you and it's gonna help you improve.
And what lured you to Purdue?
I had a real good connection with the team, the coaches. When I went there on my visit, I felt like everybody knew me before I even got there. When I got there, the coach would say, "Oh, this is Kyle Webb." And everybody said, "Oh, this is Kyle Webb." it was a great feeling knowing that I was welcome, not only on the team, but with the staff.
What division are they in?
They're a D1 school.
D1 school.
They're in the Big Ten.
Right. Now, if you compare what times you're running now to, say, the championships in the D1 at the end of the school year, how do you rate?
My personal best, I would have been up there. I would have made finals for sure, but probably top five. I haven't done that much research.
Okay, so do you believe in your talent enough to take you even further in the D1?
Yeah, if you believe you can achieve, like this girl used to always tell us in high school.
Okay. What would you consider your specialty of the events that you do? What would you consider you want to make a name for yourself with?
I personally love the 200, but Troy thinks I can progress in the 400.
Yeah, tell Troy this. How many bands in the 400 and how many bands in the 2? Once you come off the band in the 2, you got to be straight.
But usually what Troy tells me is right. Sometimes I don't believe in myself. I think Troy knows me better than I know me on the track.
Well, I mean, he would be one with a lot of experience and know. He tends to look at a body structure and somebody getting out of the blocks and how well you can recover out of the blocks. If you're not a fast starter, obviously you're going to need more time to make that up, to catch it up. So, how has your starts improved since you've been in Arizona?
I got real strong this year, so preseason I got really strong. So my starts have been on. I've been really good.
So we'll be looking to see how you get out of those blocks.
I don't know. It all depends on the day.
I'm just
excited to be back home. I'm ready for the national championships. And I'm just ready to have some fun. Some big competition going to be out there.
All right. And I guess your introductory to Bermuda, you brought some good weather, somewhat. It's been off and on raining. If you went home tomorrow and you had to tell someone about Bermuda what you've learned so far, what would it be?
I would just say that the people are so friendly. Like, just walking down the street, you just say hi to everybody and it doesn't matter. So I feel like Kyle and Troy know everybody on the island.
They do.
They're famous. So I would just say that it's an absolutely beautiful place as well as the people. So
the good thing is that come Saturday morning, there'll be a lot of people calling you by your first name. I saw you running last night. What style of runner are you? When I say style, I know you said you like to start off fast, but people have styles and they have different ways of running. What would you consider yourself?
I like to get out fast. Depending on the race and depending on the competition, I like to be out front because having those people behind me, it pushes me. But sometimes I understand that having people in front of me, that also helps. So it just depends on what time I'm trying to get and what the competition is and what the particular goal for the meet is.
How do you warm up for your 800?
I do like a series of active warm-up with some stretches, and then I get a light run in and then some build-ups and spike.
So you're generally out, what, an hour before your race?
Typically, yes.
Yeah. So, hour out warming up, and then people will say, for 2 minutes?
Yep, they get that a lot.
Yeah.
My parents, when they come to watch, we drove that much for a 2-minute race, so it's a good thing I compete in more than just the 8.
Yeah.
So, they say I'm worth it.
But that's some of the things that needs to happen.
Right.
And Kyle, you can attest to this. When you probably first started, you show up, if your race was 2 o'clock, you're showing up, what, 1:45?
Yeah.
But as you get into it, you learn that you need time to get the muscles right, to get everything tuned up. So how often are you out before your first heat?
It kind of depends on how big the event is, I guess. Mm-hmm. I'd be there about 2 hours before.
Right.
When I was out in Arizona, we was there. We was the first team to the track.
Oh.
Yeah, we were always there early. One track, we were there about 6 hours before we had to run. There was a high school meet before us, and right. We was there real early.
Do you think that affects you, though, getting there early, maybe sitting out in the heat, or do you feel that the psyche of being at the track is what you need to get ready?
It kind of depends on the starters, the shade, and the who's running the meet.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes when I was out there, we attended the high school meet. The same starters were starting our races, so I got to mentally focus into how long they're starting us.
Right.
I could have fun and make bets on who's gonna come out of the box first.
Right. Right.
When the starter's gonna blow the gun. So mentally preparing, so I can also sit along in the shade and relax and hydrate.
And that's actually another good point you've made. You tend to try to get the tempo of the starter, especially for the sprints, because some starters hold you longer than others, and you just have to get that. For the 800, you're kind of standing up and you're ready to go, but for the coming out of those blocks, you want to almost count that time where it's the starter's time where he says set, and then it could be 1, 2, 3, and then you know it's going. So if you watched it long enough, you will understand that that's the time you need to be ready to get out of those blocks. How many false starts have you had over there?
I think I've had about two.
Yeah.
I think I've had two.
Okay.
But practice, we normally practice trying not to false start. But,
right.
I've been getting back in the range of motion, so there's been a few false starts last week in training. But,
right.
Yesterday I was on. I was feeling great.
Because it's almost about anticipation.
Yeah. It's more or less. More. Some people have different twitch muscles.
Right.
Some are slower than others, but.
Right.
A lot of people can recover from it if they got a bad start. They're stronger than others. Some people get their feet off the ground real fast.
Right, right.